Yo, what's good, plant fam? Ian here with Extension's Youth Horticulture Education Program, and today we're going to talk about the importance of checking pH levels in hydroponics, and how you can make your own pH testing solution and test strips out of red cabbage broth.
pH is the degree of relative acidity of a substance. It is measured on a scale from 0 to 14, with 7 representing pH neutral. Whereas distilled water typically has a pH of about 7, lemon juice, containing large quantities of citric acid, has a pH of about 3, while baking soda has a more alkaline pH around 8.3. Lake Mead water, incidentally, also has a pH of about 8.3 due to all the calcium carbonate dissolved in the runoff from layers of sedimentary rock filled with fossilized shell deposits from eons ago. A nutrient solution with a pH which is balanced consistently between 5.5 and 6.5 is essential for successful hydroponic practice, as the roots need the water to be slightly acidic in order to take up the nutrients. While it's also important for soil-based gardening, soil tends to be more stable and requires less frequent monitoring of the pH levels. In hydroponics, however, the pH of your nutrient solution can fluctuate quickly and drastically, leading to reduced uptake of essential nutrients and eventually deficient and possibly diseased plants. So, we're going to make a simple testing solution that we can use to test the pH of our water for the purposes of monitoring plant health. If you have ever used or seen someone else use testing strips or a pH kit to test the levels in your pool, we're basically making a simple version of that in the form of a solution, or, if you're feeling creative, actual test strips. For today's project, you will need a head of red or purple cabbage, a large bowl, a cutting board, a knife, a strainer or cheesecloth, and about a gallon of distilled water. If you want to make pH strips, you also need white paper coffee filters. First, chop or grate the cabbage into small pieces, then place these in your bowl. Next, boil the distilled water and pour over the chopped cabbage in the bowl, just enough to cover the top of the cabbage. Let it sit for about 30 minutes, and then use your strainer or cheesecloth to strain the red cabbage broth. The resulting dark purple water is your testing solution. You can either pour this into a glass container like a mason jar and store it in the fridge for later, or if you want to make test strips, you can soak your white coffee filters in the purple solution for 5 to 10 minutes and then set them aside to dry. After they dry, use the scissors to cut them into strips. To use your solution, simply take a small cup of the water you want to test and put a few drops of your purple cabbage pH testing solution into the cup. If it turns red or pink, the pH is acidic, below 7. If it turns blue, green, or yellow, the pH is alkaline, which means it's above 7. If it stays purple, the pH is neutral, which means at or around 7. The strips work the same way. You just place one of your strips in the water you want to test and wait about 30 seconds for the colors to change. Congratulations! You just made your own chemistry lab equipment from plants you can grow at home. You can also try this recipe with red grapes, plums, pluots, red apple skins, pomegranates, and even dark red rose petals and see which of these gives you the best results. Keep experimenting, plant fam, and don't forget to follow YHEP and other extension programs on Facebook at www.facebook.com/UNRExtension.